Welcome learners, this is the second part of the video lecture on organizational behavior. In my earlier video lecture, I have already discussed about the concept of human behavior, nature of organizational behavior, concept of self theory and concept of ability. In this lecture, I'll be discussing about the concept of learning and learning theories. Learning outcome of this video lecture are: after completion of this presentation, you will be able to describe the concept of learning and learning theories. Then you will be able to describe the concept of values, and you will also be able to describe the concept of attitudes. So first, let us discuss the concept of learning and learning theories. Learning occurs when any relatively permanent change in behavior that occurs as a result of experience. We can say that changes in behavior indicates that learning has taken place and that the learning is a change in behavior. So basically there are three learning theories were there, which we will be discussing here. So first theory is classical conditioning. As discussed in your self-learning material, this theory is also known as Pavlovian theory. So here, a learning process that occurs when two stimuli are repeatedly paired. A response which is at first elicited by the second stimulus is eventually elicited by the first stimulus alone. Just think about the dog and the meat situation, which we have explained in our self-learning material. So this theory is known as classical conditioning theory. Then let us discuss the second theory of learning, that is operant conditioning. Operant conditioning argues that behavior is a function of its consequences. People learn to behave to get something they want or to avoid something they don't want. Operant behavior means voluntary or learned behavior, in contrast to reflexive or unlearned behavior. The tendency to repeat such behavior is influenced by the reinforcement or lack of reinforcement brought about by the consequences of the behavior. Therefore, reinforcement strengthens our behavior and increases the likelihood that will be repeated. So here, for example, we can just think of, suppose we don't study properly, then we will be fail in that exam. So because of the fear of failing in the exam, we will study properly. This is a kind of operant conditioning. Then again, we can consider, suppose if a person performs well in the organization, then the boss will praise him, the boss will give him or her promotion. So to get a promotion in the job, the employee will perform well. This is another kind of operant conditioning. Then comes the third theory, that is social learning theory. Individuals can also learn by observing what happened to the other people, and just by being told about something, as well as by direct experiences. So for example, much of what we have learned comes from watching models like parents, teachers, peer group, motion pictures and television performances, bosses and so forth. So in this theory, what they say is that individual learns from the society. Whatever we see, whatever we observe, that reflects in our learning process. Now we will discuss about values. Values are learned from the society, and here are acceptable to the society as preferred mode of conduct or end state. Values are stable and long-lasting beliefs about what is important in a variety of situations. They are evaluative standards that help us distinguish between right and wrong or good and bad in the world. So what is value system? The term value system implies a ranking of individual values relating to obedience, freedom, pleasure, self-respect, equality, punishment, etc., according to their importance. The value system is a framework of personal philosophy which governs an individual's influences, its reactions and responses to various situations. So values are moralistic in nature, fewer in number than attitude, and most central to an individual and relatively permanent and resistant to change, guide actions and judgment across specific objects or situations. So value system, in a value system, we can say that the values are moralistic in nature. Each person has got some values for something, and it is very much resistant to change. It is basically permanent in nature. So values do not operate in isolation. Several values interact with each other to form value system in a society. So value system is composed of basically two categories. One is your instrumental values and another one is terminal values. So let's discuss what is instrumental value and what is terminal value. Instrumental value is, it refers to single belief that a specific mode of conduct, that for example, suppose courage, honesty, cleanliness, is personally and socially preferable in all situations with respect to all objects. It is a tool or means for reaching terminal values. And in terminal values, this refers to the belief that a particular end state of existence, suppose for example, prosperity, world peace, freedom, equality, etc., is personally and socially worth striving for. Just consider this example. A person may desire and strive to achieve prosperity. This is an example of terminal values. By being ambitious and hardworking. So this will be your instrumental values. Now let us discuss the concept of attitude. Attitudes are evaluative statements. They respond one's feeling either favorably or unfavorably to persons, objects or an events. In other words, attitude reflects how one feels about something. It may be some person, it may be some object, or it may be any event. So formation of attitudes. Attitudes are not inherited. These are acquired or learned by the people from the environment in which they interact. The formation of attitude is broadly classified into two sources. One is direct experience and another one is social learning. Suppose you have got some experience with some situation. From that you can either have positive attitudes toward that event, or you might have negative attitudes towards that event. Again, in any society, whenever we see, observe something, we form attitudes with from our peer group, from our family members, etc. So that one is called as social learning. Hope you have understood this video lecture. See you again with another video lecture. Thank you.